Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to this evening's Dota 2 Canada Cup Season 4 game. It is our best of three series between Union Gaming and Champions of Summoner's Rift, aka X-Fire, the squad that absolutely dominated that first game. They were absolutely unstoppable in Union Gaming. They've got to find a way to deal with it. They played so damn well with these five players. We'll see how they play up here in game number two. As always, I'm joined by Joke Master Extraordinaire Mott Pax and Mr. Gurk himself, who, of course, didn't wait until Canada Cup was over to start his Gurk Live show. Give it up for what a sip, ladies and gentlemen. Greg, how are you, man?
I'm doing good, man. I'm hoping for a slightly closer game than the last, as it looked like a rollover in the last game.
Yeah, it was ridiculous.
Union Gaming may have not learned from their mistakes, however.
They pick up a stronger support in the Venge, though. That is something that I do like. They picked the Enigma last time, and I think the biggest problem was that the Enigma wasn't doing anything in lane. We talked about how Disruptor is kind of just a bad hero in lane, especially against the two heroes he went against, which was the Axe Dazzle. They also banned out the Axe. They don't want to have to deal with that aggro tri-lane or aggro dual lane shenanigan kind of stuff again, so Union Gaming make sure they go the right way. They grab the Disruptor, they grab the Juggernaut, they grab the Vengeful Spirit, and Champions of Summoner's Rift will have to deal with what they've got. They pick up the Phoenix. Demon had a really good line game last game. And let's see. I guess
Demon was owning, dude.
Yeah, it was ridiculous.
Demon was owning. That is the only way to say it. I mean, he had a very fast Blink Dagger. He had some very, very good Earth Spikes. I mean, you know, we're praising X-Fire, but honestly, Union got just completely rolled on and everywhere. I mean, even the jungle, I feel like, did not do as well as it probably should have.
Well, he was level 6 at like 9 minutes when that should happen at 4.5 minutes. And you can't really say that Champions of Summoner's Rift did anything to stop him from jungling. One of his camps was warded. Other than that, he wasn't really picked off. They didn't really rotate for him. They didn't head into the jungle. So that's pretty much on him. So Z-Talk had a bit of trouble there for Union Gaming. And hopefully they pick some heroes that allow him to flourish a bit better, because in this game, they have to win or else they're out of it. This is the last game for them in the tournament if they lose. So there's a lot of pressure on them. They go for the Magnus, the big playmaker himself, and he'll have to try to somehow stifle his Lycan, because the Lycan pick for Champions of Summoner's Rift, it's another hero like the Troll in that last game that could snowball if played correctly for banning the Slim Jam, which I imagine that will be his hero, but it also could be Brax. We'll wait and see.
Yeah, I also did want to say, Canada Cup right now on their at Dota 2 Canada on Twitter, there is a giveaway for the SteelSeries Siberia, the Dota edition that comes with the Scythe of Vice, as well as a G2A $10 gift card. Of course, that's brought to you by SteelSeries and G2A.com, but check that out. It's actually nice. I do own this headset, so I can actually, you know, I feel okay about selling out about it. It's a nice headset.
I own a headset as well from SteelSeries, but it's like the 9H, which I love. So there's that. It's good products.
There you go. Yeah. Giveaway, $10. Buy games from the best video game store ever. I love that video.
That ad is my soul. Yeah, it's pretty great.
Speaks to my soul. But we're through the draft. Last stages here. Queen of Fan picked up. The Brood Mom is banned out. Enigma, Tidehunter, Clockwork. Enigma ban. I guess it's reasonable.
That game was a lot closer because Z-Talk had some really big black holes. Say what you will about his jungle.
If he hadn't hit those black holes, that game would have been over much earlier.
25 minutes, maybe. Something like that. Well, the SF pick coming out for Union Gaming. They're going to send the Magnus maybe safe lane or the Shadowfiend safe lane. We'll have to wait and see what they decide to do. Queen of Pain for Brax, Banana Slam Gemma is going to be on that Lycan. BSJ, if you will. I'm going to call him that from now on. Let's go.
BSJ, we're starting it.
Yeah, I think it's already. I saw people in his chat calling him BSJ, so I think it's already a thing. But I'm gonna pretend that it wasn't a thing before this.
I'm gonna pretend I'm Bulba and pretend that I invented it. Got him.
Oh man.
Well, they've got, you know, Union Gaming this time around. They've got Papa Pueto on the Shadow Fiend, and my limited knowledge of the Spanish language, I believe that means Father who I am able to. So maybe he's an able father. Maybe he can carry.
I think
maybe
that's,
he's able to carry.
Maybe like Big Dad. Big
Pueto
Daddy.
Means
yo,
I am
it means
able
Big
to.
Daddy, dude. That's what it means.
All right, that might Big be. Daddy. Fog's about to flame the living shit out of us for a bad
is he watching?
Skills. Oh, yeah, of course.
Yanni's already flamed me for a cast the other day. I don't think I deserve
it. He's back
it.
For more.
Yeah, Yanni's is like, he's like the biggest flamer who doesn't deserve to flame because he just ditches everybody every time. I mean, I love you, Yanni's, but listen, man, you gotta relax, dude. Just take it easy, all right?
Well, some introductions here. X-Fire, a.k.a. Summoner's Rift, and oh my god, my dog is barking, which never happens. Sorry about that.
You know, I wouldn't have even known if you didn't say anything.
Well, I said it. Banana Slam Jamma, a.k.a. BSJ, a.k.a. Impressive Troll Warlord. He's on the Lycanthrope. He's actually going to be fucking mad this time around on the Lion, Bugatti 420 on the Phoenix to support Zeus this time around. And that's going to be on Demon and Braxxaxxaxxaxx on the Queen of Pain. I missed that name.
That was a good name. Greedy. Banana Slam Jamma's leading the way. Mad's going to walk in. He has Earth Spike. He's going to try to maybe get a skewer out of this. Mad. That was awkward. 30 seconds. Why is Disruptor on a catfish? Oh, here we go. Mudpax, this is not a pause. You're not allowed to do this.
I think he's just making an observation, dude. It does kind of look like a catfish.
Oh, well, I guess that's not a joke. God, I'm the worst person.
It's like a red catfish. Can you step out of the trees,
please? Yeah, the trees really make this difficult. There we go. All
right. That's better. I mean, that looks like a catfish.
That is 100% a catfish.
Good stuff. Valve,
my immersion, dude.
Well, they're going to go for the bottom rune this time around. And whoa, Demon!
What?
Oh, boy.
What happened?
He got skewered.
Deep hit 3-2-2.
Skewered, bro.
Deep hit 3-2-2. First blood and the bounty rune for Big Daddy. Kotar. Oh, Jesus. I'm not even going to try saying this.
EG.
Papa.
Oh, I don't know what that word means. Kortarlos.
Get over to that
Google Translate. My Spanish isn't that good, dude.
For Union Gaming, we have Papa Poito Kortarlos on the Shadow Fiend. Top lane is going to be Nightmare on the Disruptor yet again, hoping to have a better game than that last one. Z-Talk and the Vengeful Spirit. Ben Haas again on the Juggernaut. Down bottom, it is the offlane Magnus, played by Greedy. A great name, to be sure. So some interesting late setups here. And they already get the first blood. They already get the Bounty Rune as well in that bottom rune spot. Pretty solid start. They actually got both Bounty Runes. That's huge. Both Bounty Runes plus first blood. Oh, my. That is a problem.
Now, that's a heavy starting advantage. And, you know, I'm going to check out this Phoenix, brother. I like this Phoenix pick here. I think the Fire Spirits are going to be pretty good. He is going to have to be careful. Nothing weird happens with Dive. And
he's just going to get Glimpse Band. Phoenix plus Glimpse is like, I don't know like how you survive in this lane.
I feel like Brax should gank this lane really early and try to give the Phoenix a little bit of a head start. And then Phoenix will be okay. Like, yeah. I feel like if you have good levels in Fire Spirits, then you'll just be able to toss one at Disruptor, toss a couple at Juggernaut. They're going to be real sad.
Demon did Lightning Bolt here, was able to find this Observer Ward placed at the pull spot, or the pull through spot, I should say, and Demon will be able to counter ward it quickly. So, extra 50 gold for him. Does go for the early Lightning Bolt to make sure they have that counter ward option. Doesn't go for the Arc Lightning to say take out a jungle stack or anything, but that's fine. Bugatti getting zoned out pretty heavily, just trying to leech experience here. He's level 1. The Magnus is level 2, so already This Phoenix feels like it's forced. I like the hero, but like in this lane, it's not easy. Like, I don't know how you're able to leech experience or do anything for that matter.
Yeah, the Vench being here actually is going to muck things up quite a bit. It's a good stun, especially against Phoenix.
He got a Haste rune. They saw him. They have that
Observer Ward. This is a ganky Phoenix.
I mean, he's just going to harass this Shadow Fiend. This Shadow Fiend, by the way, has 3 Necromastery stacks at 2 minutes into the game. I think
he wants to get the crow here. Actually, this is going to be really inconvenient for the Shadow Fiend.
Yeah, he's
I know
super
this Phoenix
behind.
Is hanging out now, and just kind of has to deal with it. Phoenix is going to go on a James Bond mission right here.
Does he know this courier's here? I don't think so.
No, I don't know. He knows.
They did this last game, and Demon was able to walk through and kill the courier on the Radiant side. Bugatti is going to get right-clicked once, and he just made so much work for Papa. Like, he doesn't get any experience in this mid lane for a period of time. He misses out on a lot of CS. Brax will deny a couple of creeps from him.
They want to kill Greedy in the bottom lane.
They're going to try to go. They Lightning Bolt him, but he's so far behind the tower that he's fine. This does allow Banana Slam Jamma to start putting pressure on the tier 1 tower in this bottom lane. Maybe starting to go for an early tower push, but it'll take some time.
Offlane Magnus is something we have not seen in a while. And I actually like this hero in the offlane quite a bit. Especially when there are 2 stuns.
Oh, Jesus. Oh, God. That's our fault. Mothpax versus the Ping, buddy. Kinetic Field? Brax is going to try to man up. Nightmare, I don't know if this is your fight.
He should be okay.
He's got a bottle up. Oh, that Siege Creep canceling the bottle. And he does have Blink. He's going to blink away. That Blink range, though. That level 1's pretty good. Top lane, Icarus Dive. Ben Haas was harassing Bugatti. He got me.
Dude. Got him!
That's, you're so good.
I mean, to be honest, I think you know, given that the bottle was so delayed there, the Shadow Fiend was a little bit messed up on his timings. But that's a really important kill there for Brax. And this is kind of an interesting lane. You know, I personally have trouble with this lane on Queen of Pain because, bottom rune. Matt gets it.
David's fine. Yeah, Matt gets the rune. That's huge.
You know, you have to be very careful now at these levels, because as soon as there's a couple levels in Rays, if you try to do anything aggressive and don't kill him, then you pretty much always either die or become very, very close to dying, because it's almost impossible to either get in or get out without eating two raises, and two level three raises is quite a lot of damage, much more than Queen of Pain can really take. So interesting lane here, but mostly I just wanted to credit Brax, good execution. Able to grab that kill on Shadow Fiend.
Bugatti is still... He just hit level 2 at 4.5 minutes of the game. Magnus is like level 4. So yeah, that's a problem. They also take the tier 1 tower. As good as this mid lane is going for Summoner's Rift, that offlane is going pretty poorly. Demon's going to get right-clicked by Greedy. Arc Lightning goes. He's out of mana. Earth Spike went for Matt as, I guess, the Lycan's rotating into the jungle. They're going to actually secure farm for your support line, because again, getting an early blink dagger, as we saw in the last game, is huge for your effectiveness in the game, and I think is going to be,
you know, there's a couple supports where you see them like farming in the side lane like this being very, very effective, and he's definitely near the top of the list with the blink dagger, just a humongous upgrade on the hero, having the instant speed disable with the hex in combination with the blink, extremely effective, especially against a hero like a Magnus. You can chain that together, and then the Earth Spike, get a really, really good early initiation. Good against the Shadow Fiend as well. Make sure he can't react it against... Even it's good against the Juggernaut, because he can't Blade Spin then. There's a lot of really good reasons to go for this early Blink Dagger.
Bugatti getting dove up here in the top
lane. He has to wait for the Lightning Strike to go away. Very annoying.
Yeah, he does time it perfectly, though. The Kinetic Field came out. He'll actually salve up as well. Oh, top right, Sonic Wave going for that solo kill. Can't get it. Brax out of mana. He's going to have to bottle up to try to blink away. He's going to maybe man fight on Z-Talk. He'll try to TP out, and he'll make it. No screaming paid for Brax. Instead, he'll try to chase after the Shadow Fiend, but he's already gone. Shadow Strike was going for a long period of time. He survives.
Yeah, he actually dropped the Wraith Band to use his stick to make sure he got full HP out of that when he was at such a low life. So good conservation move there.
It's a ballsy play, but I guess it works out. Finally, this Bugatti Phoenix getting experience, which he desperately needs. They are rotating a Nightmare on the backside, which they did see. Bugatti realizes this. He doesn't have Fire Spirits. He has Icarus Dive. Thunderstrike's going to go. Kinetic Field as well. Scream of Pain. Icarus Dive goes through. Nightmare's going to try to TP out. He is going to make it. Nope. Arc Lightning gubs it from Demon. Just barely. Actually, sir, going down. Benhaz does have Blade Fury. He'll use it. The Shadow Strike. Not really connecting there. And yeah, Benhaz will be fine.
Good news here is Benhaz is off to a much better start than in the last game. Early level on CS. Banana Slam Jamma is still just jungling. I think they're going to be content to give the Lion as much experience as possible, as much farm as possible. And Banana Slam Jamma, is he going to be going? I'm interested to see exactly what kind of item build he goes on. Honestly, this is a player I'm not very familiar with.
Looks like he's going Midas.
Yeah, I mean, he has the gloves of haste, so I guess he's going to go Midas here. And that means that Summoner's Rift are going to be content with dragging this game out a little bit.
I mean, I think they need to. This Phoenix does nothing early game, because level 1 ult is pretty terrible, although they don't have like a troll or anything. Their right click, not the best. They have like Benhaz, that's it, actually. I guess the SF2 is pretty good, but yeah, I don't know. I feel like at this point they have to wait until they get a blink on the Lion. They don't want to fight with without that. Maybe get level 6 for the Zeus, who's only level 4 currently. He's going to go for a Sol Ring. So they're waiting for a lot of items, I think, before they really start putting pressure on some of these towers and some of these heroes. They also, he's definitely, I think, going Midas at this point. He's 1,000 gold. He's a 500 gold away from it. It's late, obviously, but he went for Boots first. He's got a Basilius as well. He bought a bottle as well, so just a lot of farm before he picks up that Midas.
Yeah, I think Brax is going to be the one that creates the space here.
Z-Talk. And,
oh, Z-Talk looks dead. Yeah, they got him.
You were away from Greedy.
Pickoffs with Demon and Brax helping.
He's going to go Shockwave. That'll actually save his life. Banana Slam Jamba probably not going to die for that kill.
Brax just got a solo kill on the SF once again, so he is proving to be very, very, very adept at this matchup. And, you know, I have to be completely honest. In the last couple of weeks leading up to today, and there was like one Storm Spirit game the other day, I'd been fairly unimpressed with Brax, but he played very well in the last game. he's playing very well in this game, and he played very well in that Storm Spirit game, I think, over the weekend. So, I don't know. Maybe he's improving a little bit, getting more comfortable with the changing rosters. You know, he has different players rotating for him, and that can make a really big difference, especially since he's, you know, the drafter. I think he makes a lot of the in-game decisions as well. So, a lot to juggle as a mid player, and it seems like he at least he's a little bit more comfortable with this roster, able to excel a little bit more.
There was a point in time where Brex was considered one of the best in NA, and then he moved to China and started playing for LGD International, and all that went by the wayside. And he played okay in LGD International, but since then his play had gone downhill. And then he's back here playing for Summoner's Rift, and he has a lot to prove, obviously, and still a long time before we see, you know, maybe his full potential. But he's playing well this matchup. Like you talked about, a couple of solo kills for Brax, 1,000 gold in the bank. His farm is really good. Bottom lane, Demon. Maybe in trouble. Greedy chasing him down. Wave of Terror is going to go through. Magic Missile. He should fall. They skewer him. Rest even to secure the kills. Yeah, they get the kill. TP coming in. Finger. Nightmare walks through. He's going to die to the wolves or Brax's right click. One of the two. They're going to chase after Greedy. I don't think they go for him. But okay, counter kill coming out. Support for a support.
You know, I have to say that X-Fire has to be really happy with, you know, beyond the Phoenix, how these first couple of minutes have gone, especially how well Brax has dealt with the Shadow Fiend, because it's only 10, it's 10 minutes and Shadow Fiend only has 64 CS. And I say only 64 because usually we see Shadow Fiends going after stacked camps, you know, getting a lot more CS than, you know, the normal. Well, if he has 50, he's in good shape. Although Demon is just dead. Jesus, he needs to stop dying.
This is the story of the support, Zeus. If you're out of position, you are going to die. I mean, you don't have anything to stop anybody from killing you early on in the game, and let alone a Juggernaut who decides to Omni Slash you. That's just a kill that's going to happen 9 times out of 10. So, easy kill for Ben Haas. He gets that done. Last time BSJ played Lycan, he went Vlad's Trids BKB. He finished 16-2 and 14 in a win against Black Sheep. They had a Lion and Phoenix in that game as well. The difference of this game is that he is going for that Midas, so he in fact has it. He's had it for some time. He's also flying out a set of treads, so he's not even going for the early Vlads here, which is fine. He's not on the dire side.
Yeah, that's fine. He can still jungle, you know, with the wolves tanking. It's not that big of a deal. Treads give him the extra attack speed, so that you might even argue that's a little bit more efficient, but that is definitely on the shopping list, and Banana Slam Gemma. He's going to be... I mean, he has 87 CS. This guy knows how to hit creeps.
Brax walks up to Greedy. He got a little upset that he was canceling his RP animation. He doesn't really seem to give a damn. Mid lane, maybe a fight brewing. Nightmare leading the way up front. Wave of Tear goes. Mad and Demon are going to back the hell up. They're just going to farm. Mad's just like, I want a Blink Dagger. And he is... We talked about the 15-minute blink from Demon. Mad's going to have this at 12. So there's that.
They've given it to him, though, you know?
True. I guess that's what happens when you pick up the jungle. Jungle Lycan plus Lion seems so good if you know what you're doing with it. Like, you just send the Lycan to the jungle. You send the Lion to the lane. Meanwhile, Blink... Actually, Mad got glimpse back. He's going to get blown up. He did buy his Blink Dagger, thank God. Oh, man. Oh, that would have been awful if he didn't buy that.
Yeah, that certainly would have been less than ideal. But now it's fine. I mean... He died, whatever. It's mostly annoying because Shadow Fiend got it.
Yeah, that's actually a big pickup. That provides him a lot of farm. He is going for the Yules. He has the Yules, I think. Does he have the Voidstone? Yeah, he does. He has a full Yules at 12 and a half minutes, so. As good as Brax did, doesn't have a full Yules yet. He's going for the Orkin instead, so. What's more? Let's find out here. Yules, I'm sure, is a little bit less. Actually, a lot less. 2850 to 4,025. 4,125. It's a bit of a difference. Although DD Run now on SF as well.
Well, moving forward, Union have picked up a couple of good kills here. They found the Shadow Fiend, a little bit of momentum. The Yules is nice because you can obviously use it in combination with the ultimate and just get free kills. If you position that correctly, you can just destroy people.
Yeah, I mean, they'll be right next to you when you use them up in the air, and then you just pop up your ultimate. And boom, shakalaka.
Honestly, ever since they fixed that thing where if you're, like, right in the middle, you take double because you get hit by both rounds of souls. Like, it's actually... It's so good now, Yules. We never really saw it before that change, and it's... I don't know. It's nice.
It's frightening. Benhaz, we haven't really talked about him. He is Yasha. He just picked that up. I imagine SMY, but also Manta's an option. They don't have Silence. They're going to have an Orchid, so I guess Manta might be an okay choice. That seems to be something that he could go for. We'll see. And we will wait and see whether he picks up the SMY or the Manta. I definitely think Manta's the better option, though. Meanwhile, okay, I thought those were kills. They just bottle up illusions, and I got really confused for a second.
Like, nothing's happening. Well, nothing is happening, honestly. Everyone is just farming, and I think Summoner's Rift have to be just happy with that. Benhaz is getting to the point where he's going to be pretty scary in the mid-game. He is doing much, much better than last game, and we'll have to see exactly how well this goes for him. I mean, this is so crucial, right? I mean, the next couple minutes, especially after the Quap gets the Orchid, potentially you just get blinked on, Orchided, and killed. And that would certainly be an issue.
And he could do that.
Phoenix also has gone up to level 8. Phoenix has done a good job
he's
here.
Still not level 2. Oh, they just fingered poor Vengeful Spirit. And they even do something as well.
That just buys them time, right? Those finger kills. This is exactly what Fire wants.
It buys them time, but they're still going to try to gank bottom. Demon's like, I need to leave.
Yeah, Demon's just dead again.
I think he's dead. They're going to try to TP some heroes in, but I'm your
god too.
I don't know if you kill anybody here. Yeah, they don't. They don't kill anybody, apparently. Benhaz is going to walk in. They're kind of baiting this.
Banana Slam Jamma does not want to get ulted here.
Yeah, that's an Empower Omni Slash. That, I don't know if you try to fight into that.
I mean, the next 10 minutes or so, this Juggernaut's
going to be
a menace,
but they
blink forward.
Sonic Wave's going to go, and that is the Orc, and now done for Brax Problems. But he Sunray onto Z-Talk. They blow up that Juggernaut. That might be the big thing that I think Summoner's Rift needs. Maybe push a Tier 1 tower or get something else off the map.
Well, there you go. Blink Dagger. Blink Dagger on the Lion. Huge advantage for them. And they have two instant speed initiations against the Juggernaut. They have Blink Orchid, which is just about done, 25 gold. And Blink Hex. Both of those things are basically impossible for the Juggernaut to deal with, and will certainly give Summoner's Rift some time and some game against this, because if the Juggernaut doesn't get exactly the engagement he wants, then he's just going to get crushed, right? Because there's just those two instant speed disables are going to destroy him.
Well, at least until he gets Mantis style to deal with the Orchid.
Yeah. I mean then he's still going to have to deal with Blink. You know, they have tons of burst damage. Oh, boy.
Wow. Greedy actually gets that Blink Dagger off. I think he might have been smoked up. I'm not sure why that didn't cancel his Blink Dagger. They get the kill. Lycan goes down. That was a really good Zeus ult. For some reason, that didn't cancel the Blink. They might have been smoked. I didn't see. Yeah, must have been.
Now they're just going to push bottom lane, and this is a good example where the Juggernaut's going to get whatever he wants. Move in on this one. Glimpse coming in.
Bugatti.
Put some damage on Bugatti
Blink
here.
Raise? Nope. Requiem doesn't go. The Supernova, they were trying to get
He's
that used.
Though.
He will use the Supernova. Does a lot of damage to Papa Pueto. They buy back on the Lycan. They're going to jump in. Orchid onto Papa. I don't think that's going to kill him. He needs right click. That will kill him. The Lightning Bolt coming in. Now there's going to be the ult coming out from Banana Slam Jamma, but he took so much damage.
I mean, he cannot go near the Juggernaut. Juggernaut will just destroy him.
He doesn't have his Omni Slash. He just used it. I think that was on the Lycan. Meanwhile, they do get the advantage, but...
Yeah, but I mean, he just like... No, he didn't even Omni. He just like ran up, right-clicked him a couple times, and he was just like almost dead.
A buyback he used for a couple of kills and a defense of the Tier 1 tower, which they do deny. But...
That's worth it, I think.
Yuen Gaming getting a couple of kills. Benhaz starting to work here. He is going to have the Mantis style flying out to him right now, so a big choice for Benhaz. A big pickup, I should say.
Smoke purchased up here by Jimmy, so they're going to try to get an engagement. Smoke up. I wonder what kind of item we're going to go see here for Phoenix. I'm not too well versed in Phoenix competitive items, especially
Midas.
When you're behind like this.
You go like Midas, generally you get an armor which he doesn't have. They're going to hex up on Brody. He should be dead. Big Earth Spike. He was about to skewer away. His animation was going. They get the kill. Pretty big kill there. And Sunray is actually such a good ability, too. Does so much damage. They burst him down with the Earth Spike and with the hex as well. Pretty big fight coming out from Summoner's Rift. Like you were talking about for the Phoenix, I generally think you go Midas to get levels, and then you pick up like an urn plus, say, a Shiva's axe is pretty good. They finger Nightmare. Goodbye. Another Sunray kill. Two dead. They go back in after the fake back. And they get two kills, but Benhaz is nearby.
Oh, they have Fire Spirits. He does not have Omni.
He has Blade Fury, though. Matt is trying to juke as best as possible. He has Blink Dagger. Oh, almost got it off. almost survives. Meanwhile, mid lane, Papa Poito needs to be careful. TP from Brax. The Eel Scepter's going to go. Brax does have his Orchid. Oh, the blink out.
Nice blink.
Papa Poito. He's going to go in anyways. Brax pops it. RP! Greedy got hit up by the last tick of that. Papa Poito goes down to the Orchid. Oh, no. That RP. He's going to keep going. Brax, the skewer's not there. The shockwave, double kill. Meanwhile, Arc Lightning, not enough to get that kill onto the Magnus. I think Brax goes in too hard there. TP away coming out from Demon. Banana Slim Jam is going to run as well. He's going to be fine.
He does get a kill on the other mid, so toss up. But overall, Summoner's Rift actually ahead in XP. Gold is fairly even. Pretty negligible differences, however. Very negligible, actually.
That's
and,
a 20 minutes. The gold's almost exactly even. It's like a 500 net worth lead for Union Gaming, yeah. But even that is nothing.
Well, Benhaz is going to instead just move into the Roche pit, try to take this down. There is a Zeus ult, so they can scout this out. They seem to know this is happening. I think you're right about that, Mont.
They had the wards. They saw him walk in. I don't think he smoked into it either.
No, he didn't.
They know that Brax is down. They're going to try to fight this anyways.
Well, this is he kills the healing ward. They need to go, though, like right now.
No, they can't. They don't have any initiation. He's got to kill it. Lycan might deny it. They denied it. He got it. He snatches it. He gets it done.
He gets the Roche kill.
Yeah, I got the Roche kill. Did not get the Aegis, though. No deny coming up for Banana Slam Jamma. Good try, though. They get the Roche kill. Did not get the Aegis. And they also kill the Phoenix with Zikra's diving and seemed to. He lost his way, but that was very confusing for a moment. But he got the Roche kill. For the Radiant team, Aegis was used, or picked up, rather, for the Juggernaut. So he got bashed at the last second, I believe, and could get that last right click. That was impressive.
Yep, absolutely. And unfortunately, I think he rather would have gotten the Aegis there, or killed the Aegis, but they'll definitely take the money in the bank. We'll see how this game progresses. I think a lot of it is going to come down to the engagements onto Benhaz. The Aegis is certainly going to make this more complicated.
Hey, I don't think you fight into that. I think you just kind of back up and farm. I mean, you have a Lycan. He's going to have an Assault Kuros here in a second. And they actually, with a team that has a Lycan, they're not getting any towers. They haven't gotten a single one. They will get Nightmare in the mid-time in the mid lane with another Finger. So there is that. But they have yet to get a Tier 1 tower in this game. And that's really where the gold difference comes from. Summoner's Rift might have a kill advantage, but Union Gaming have all of the towers. And they desperately need towers for Summoner's Rift to stay in this game, I think. And I just can't believe they haven't taken a single tier one. It's really hard to push into RP, obviously, but still.
Yeah, I mean, I definitely agree with you, but I feel like Banana Slam Jamma is, at least so far, seems to be a much less aggressive carry than most people, you know? Or at least what we've seen recently. Last game, he farmed a lot on the Troll. This game, he's farming quite a bit on Lycan, just trying to be as efficient as possible.
Yeah. I'm just super surprised he hasn't really gone for a Tier 1 tower push. I guess he realizes that it's just super hard for him to push, especially without a BKB, and he's not even going for one anytime soon. But his effectiveness for pushing towers is a lot heavier now with his Assault Kuros.
Well, you're right. He still goes for Hand of Midas. So,
God. That's not the latest Midas timing I've seen.
I mean, Demon just got one, too.
That's unusual. That is kind of strange.
I mean, I would have thought he would have bought, like, a Four Staff with that money, but...
All right.
They're just going to try to put this. I think they're just going to try to push this game as late as possible.
They just bought one for Matt as well. They have three. They have four Midases on their team.
Well,
this kind of got out of hand quickly.
Next 5 minutes, if they don't lose, they're going to be in good shape.
I mean, that's the key, isn't it? Just don't lose the game with.
I mean, there are certainly. I mean, they just spent 2K on an item that does nothing for a while, so.
Hey, I got some extra tax speech. Fine.
I mean, you can basically put them at a 6K gold disadvantage now, right?
Yeah, I think so.
At least for the next.
The numbers won't. The numbers won't tell you that, but
they don't show you that. But they spent 6,000 on items that do nothing, so it's gonna take a little bit for that return to kick in. It's a long term investment.
Yeah, the investment is for the
and
late
Shadow. You know what actually scares me the most about this? Shadow Fiend now is a BKB.
Their power curve is hitting right about now. I'd say.
Yeah, these Midases. I mean, here they're going to either going to win them the game or they're going to lose because they purchased them.
Because
I mean,
Benhaz also has a BKB that he just purchased as well.
Yeah, this scares me. I mean, we already talked about they do have at least one thing to go through the BKB will not go through it, but initiate past it.
Mad, they know exactly where Mad is. Oh, Ben Haas, he does have the Aegis, though, so even if they bring him down...
Okay.
That is not good.
What?
That was a mistake. And even if they don't do anything off the back end of that, I don't know if this is going to be... BKB's going to get popped. Now they're going to try to go in the Supernova. They'll take it down. Requiem does a little bit of work. Banana Sanjima trying to fight. Not his best engagement. Sonic Wave goes, catches the tail end of Papa. Does absolutely nothing. Finger will get the kill for Mad. A nice pick there. But meanwhile, Greedy getting silenced up. Brax is actually stuck in the trees. This is turning into a quick disaster to be out for Summoner's Rift. Blade Fury, they're going to lose three heroes here. Triple kill for Benaz. Despite him using that BKB in an awkward time, they still get three kills, and I don't know if that was really the best engagement for Summoner's Rift.
Yeah, but, I mean, that's to be expected. What did we just talk about?
Fight into two BKBs. Fight into an Aegis. I don't know about that. Good play from Union, but that's just a fight that's easy to take for them, honestly.
Yeah, I mean, that's like, they should just win that. They should absolutely just win that fight, and they did.
I'm a little worried here for Summoner's Rift.
The Supernova was out front. The
Supernova has been underwhelming. I mean, Supernova's not very good against a Mask of Madness Jug if you don't hit him with like two spirits first, you know?
Yeah, that's the problem. Gritty, you're going to not do that, buddy. That's actually fine. Bastion's going to get picked up for Brenhaz. So that's a big item. Then he'll get into Abyssal Blade, and then what do you do as the Lycan? Not much. It just feels like Summoner's Rift can't do anything this game. They can't even get tier 1 towers. I don't know how you have a game
they're
with
just
the
gonna wait.
In tier 1 towers.
I mean, this is just a game where they're going to rely on waiting. They're going to hope that Brax can get pickoffs for them. That's going to be way harder now with two BKBs, but
that's
all they can do. They can execute smoke ganks to keep them from grouping up. They can get pickoffs to keep them from grouping up. But if they group up and march down, they're going to lose every fight. Like, well, Summoner's Rift is going to lose all those fights.
I don't know if you can really take those engagements. They'll smoke into the enemy jungle, unfortunately. Union Gaming are all entirely down bottom. They're at the bottom rune spot. Papa Pueto has his blink tech we saw in the last fight, obviously. He's also got 1,000 gold. Zeus ult to scout things out. They know exactly where everyone is, but that is not in the top lane. Mad has to think about backing up and getting out of here. BSJ is sitting in the trees currently.
I mean, to be honest, the fact they're only down 3k gold when they have not gotten a single tower is pretty impressive. I think, you know, Summoner's Rift, if they don't, you know, if they don't completely fail in the next couple of minutes, are going to actually be in really good shape.
That's a lot
to take this game
for.
Back over. Yeah, but I mean, look at how much money they basically have to make up here. If they win one fight and get two tier ones, that's 2k.
Oh, they're going to bait out Benhaz. Now the ultimate coming in. Banana Slam, Jebba going to work, and then Mad with the Finger of Death. Big kill. That's a mega kill streak for BSJ.
That's a huge kill.
That is big.
He just got a ton of gold for that. He's up to 2k. He has an AC. He has a Midas. He's very, very farmed. Phoenix now going to be working towards...
And they get their first tier 1 of the game, and it wasn't denied. Brax with the DD gets the tier 1 tower top. That's even a bigger story. And he gets his Aghanim Scepter as well. It's flying out currently, so short cooldown, big damage. Pretty big.
Aghanim is now for the Queen of Pain. Honestly, I think this game's going fine for Fire. Like, the pressure's just not there from Union Gaming. I feel like, you know, maybe they should be pushing engagements a little bit harder with RP. Extremely powerful. They do have to deal with the Orchid, though. I mean, blinking in, getting Orchided is game losing. So, tower is under
attack. You know what I just realized?
What,
Blank,
Travis?
Who has been their stand-in or who has been their standout mid player for Union Gaming, not in the game. Papa Pueto, their stand-in playing for him. I'm not sure if he had to leave, if he had to go to bed. Maybe they just replaced him for the game. Who knows? But that's kind of an interesting choice coming up from Union. Flink RP onto Blank. Oh, he misses the skewer. Oh! Banana Slam Jimmy. He's still probably dead anyway.
Still dead.
Yeah. Oh.
Maybe.
All right. Meanwhile, Requiem blows up Demon, but they have to use the BKB. Sunray going, keeping Demon alive. Raze misses. Doesn't even use it. Icarus dive away. Two dead. Brax stays top. Bugatti's probably going to die here. Don't use your Supernova. Raze misses.
Use,
it. Okay, good work.
Use Areno. Your Midas Areno.
Benhaz is chasing in. Oh, he got first hit bashed. Oh, that's just That is, I would be sick if I was him. I would be super mad.
Welp.
He would have lived too, I think.
Yeah, I think so. Dyer's That's unfortunate. Is under attack. I mean, unfortunately for UG, there's no bottom lane there for them to push in. Brax is gonna try to kill Z-Talk here. Or not.
Yeah, wow, the entire team was chasing after him. Finger goes. They get the kill in the Magnus. Brax is gonna die though. I mean, they're getting these trades, and I don't know if they're worth it. I don't really think they are. They're down.
I think they're worth it. 1-for-1 trades? Well, that was not 1-for-1, but they lost the Phoenix and the Lycan. 1-for-1 trades, I think, are totally fine for Fire. Radiant's middle tower is under they just attack. Want to keep them from being able to group up and push another base, right?
Yeah.
Every time they get a 1-for-1 trade, it probably just delays the game a little bit.
I don't know, man. These fights, I guess we haven't really seen a full 5-on-5 engagement, but how do you fight?
Yeah, I mean, also, there's like these Midases are just starting to pay for themselves, you know? So, pretty soon, I think they're going to turn the corner here. That's a Yules for Lion, so he gets his first major item after Midas.
What's BSJ's next item? BKB? Or does he go for something else?
I think BKB is probably good.
I guess if you're going like man fight Lycan, which is what he kind of is going for, or I guess, yeah, it is kind of man fighty. BKB seems to be the only option that I would pick.
I think
Necrobook this late in the game is pretty terrible.
Yeah, it's pretty bad. I think we've crossed the Necrobook. We've already crossed Dyer's that. Top tower is under that bridge. Attack.
Benhaz. Ooh. Omni slash. Oh wow.
RNGesus.
Oh, that was
ice.
Smart
throw
play.
Your deep hit ice frog, pleases.
Oh, that
gets
was
glimpse back.
Oh, the status he makes gonna it get out. He's gonna get RP'd as well. Where was his team? That was awkward. Mad was there the entire time. They could have helped him out. I guess it would have been certain doom, but yeah, they threw a lot for that kill, but they do get
it.
Yeah,
I mean, they used everything, right?
So Static that's Storm, RP, Abyssal, Omni Slash. But he's still dead for 60 seconds.
20k net worth. Mopax informs us that he is quite wealthy. Living in the 1% jug life, third slot. Of the richest jugs at 30 minutes. Certainly got a lot of farm and a lot of items. That completed Abyssal Blade. And
this guy's on the lifestyles of the rich and famous.
He's got his Hollywood mansion. Got his 100-foot yacht. Ready to go. Radiant's top tower has fallen. All right, now this is actually the problem right here for Summoner's Rift, right? This next coming fight in their base. If they lose this fight, this game is going to become impossible.
I don't know how you fight into this team of Union. They don't have RP yet, luckily. That's helpful. Earthspike will go. They can blow him up, but can they blow him up twice? I don't think so. They'll walk in. Rax is exposed now. Glyph is already gone. Swap out. They're going to kill the Phoenix immediately. Sonic Wave goes. BKB. Buyback coming in from the Phoenix. They're already going to get the Rax down. Meanwhile, Benhaz destroys Brax. Requiem goes. Benhaz going to work. We might be headed to a game number 3 here. Static Storm is up. To zone out every hero, Mad buys back, flank forward, or spike. Benhaz is going to go down, but he does have Aegis. Meanwhile, they're going to go on to Nightmare Kinetic Field. Nightmare getting away, Banana Slam Jamma. Still no BKB. Ray's coming through. Hex up onto Papa Poito, about to fall. Looks like he will. Banana Slam Jamma also going to go down. He will have buyback. He's going to have to use it. Maybe. Finest use it. Brax is also down for 40 seconds. Has buyback, not using it. Omni Slash shut to Mad. He'll go down. It almost feels like Summoner's Rift are giving up, honestly. Look at this. Brax's buyback. He's had buyback since he's died. He's not using it. I guess they're just going to give up this top Rax. They know that it's done. They have to kind of just give it away.
One Rax is definitely not the death sentence here, but Union Gaming are now in a good position. They've created a huge gold lead in the last couple of minutes. And with that, they're going to try to, I think, end the game. And Benhaz is now Aegisless, but still extremely powerful. Brax is coming back up. Maybe if they get Jimmy back up in time, they can hold this next push with the blink onto the Juggernaut.
That's
bad, but
dude. You said that like 3 times.
Whatever. Jesus Christ, you're right. I did say that, dude. Like 3 times.
RP onto BSJ. Well, he just bought back. And he is dead. And that is probably the game also.
Yeah, that does not feel good. Does not feel good.
That's... Wow, that ended. I don't know if that's the game, but that... How do you defend without a Lycan? It's really on Brax at this point.
I mean, I don't understand how they're going to kill Benhaz.
Brax is going to get obliterated. BKB for Benhaz. They do bring down the Venge. The Supernova is about to fall. Ooh, just survives long enough. Benhaz has to back away. Got stunned up by the Supernova. Brax did buy back. He blinked out.
Thanks.
He actually got glimpsed. Nightbear is going to TP home. He'll make it alive. And now they'll have to wait a little bit for Union Gaming to try to finish this game off. So, Summoner's Rift have to buy out on almost every hero. In fact, yeah, all of their heroes bought back in the last fight. So, oh no. That's probably... I mean, if they just win one fight for Union Gaming, they win the game.
I'm impressed that they still have their base after that one, but... I guess that's why Brax was saving the buyback. Looks smart in the end.
So, are we of the opinion that these Midas is probably lost in the game, or...
I mean, they still could potentially win them the game, I think. I mean, one racks down is not the end of the world at this moment. But, yeah, Mopex points out, I mean, we just saw, like, disaster team fights two in a row and an entire set of buildings. That's certainly an issue. I mean, they definitely, if they do lose, it was certainly a large contributing factor. I mean, you could say maybe if Jimmy had had a four staff instead, they would have been in a favorable position. Fucking Mad could have bought a Ghost Scepter, and he's dead.
He's dead for 70 seconds, in fact, with no buyback. And he's actually the biggest deal, I think, for Benhaz to deal with. That support line has been a freaking thorn in his side. They're going to walk
I feel like this Phoenix has been pretty ineffective this game as well. I mean, pretty much every Supernova except the last one has ended up in Phoenix dying.
I don't know if I'm a fan of this hero, to be honest with you. I can't really get behind it for the specific reason
that I thought it was going to work okay in this lane, but it just did not at all.
And they're going to lose maybe another set of racks here if they're not careful. Force, they were he missed his blink. It actually got canceled by Arc Lightning. It's a good thing he canceled that animation. He was about to use it again. Benhaz pops his BKB Sonic Wave, clears the Creep Wave, but not much else. Malarax is done. Benhaz will walk back, kind of just like a badass, and proceed to head with his team towards, I guess, the jungle. Roche isn't up for a while, so that's not an option. Do the fake back, which seems to be what they're doing. I don't think Summoner's Rift go outside the base.
Connect Banana Slam Jamma again, this
Force
game...
Blank RP.
No.
Skewer is going to connect, and goodbye, Banana Slam Jamma. No buyback for him. Mad will respawn. Swap out onto Demon. Yule Scepter. Hello? What just happened? Meanwhile, Supernova's going to go big Earthspike onto four. Finger onto one. Benhaz in trouble now. He might fall. Sonic Wave onto two. Greedy getting chased down. He'll TP away. He's not going to make it out. Four dead.
Holy shit.
I mean, that is
dude,
the fight they're looking
fucking
for.
Fucking Mad is just fucking incredible.
Yeah, that Earthspike was
absolutely
insane.
I mean, that won them the fight easily because it lets the Phoenix ult explode, which gives them the extra stun time. They're two melee Roxas down now. This game is an uphill battle, but that was an incredible Earthspike, which bought them a fight. They got a lot of money off that fight as well.
Yeah, that was something else.
I'm not saying they're back into this, but now they have an Aghanim's on the Phoenix. Middle barracks are under that attack. Was a very, very favorable fight for them. It's unfortunate that Banana Slam Jamma had to die to make it happen, but...
Yeah, that was the...
I don't know if there's anything Union Gaming can really do about that. Like, they just happen to be in a line. Like, sometimes that happens against a lion. They've been playing this game fairly well, I think, and that was just unfortunate.
And that's one of those situations where you're rushing into, say, the B bomb site and whatever map that you're playing on Counter-Strike Go, and let's just say
you just get bodied.
Cash, when you and I are defending at the B bomb site, and everyone rushes in a line, and they proceed to get mowed down.
That was an unreal Earthspike. Jeez.
One after the other, Mad's like, I'll take a 4-man Earthspike, not even a problem. So apparently, actually, there's a way that if you get a 5-man Echo Slam, Valve gives you items. You should get items for, like, 4-man Earthspikes, because that shit's incredible.
That was some good stuff. Well, now I think there's going to be some contention over the next Aegis, which is going to be coming up in just under 2 minutes. I think there will be some contention over this one.
Not max duration, but pretty long duration, Rosh respawn.
Yeah, it's not a short one.
Magnus? I don't know, man. I don't know if you do try to...
I mean, maybe
this.
Not, but I feel like with a Lycan, you have to be interested in maybe sneaking it.
Also, by the way,
AC.
I want to throw this out here. I might be wrong about this. Hold on a second. But I believe that the Queen of Pain and Lycan combined have the same net worth as the Juggernaut. I'm pretty sure that's true.
That is true.
That's unbelievable to me. Juggernaut is super farmed. He is six slotted, unless he maybe gets rid of his Mask Madness buys like a butterfly. That is something else. I guess they will try to contend this. Contest this, excuse me. There's a smoke for Summoner's Rift.
I mean, this could be their undoing, right? They have Thunder God's Wrath, but fighting against an RP near the pit, fighting against an SF ulti, very, very scary, and that spamming is actually infuriating.
The SF, by the way, is Blank or Sora. Yeah, he was dancing. That was kind of funny. He was dancing right here on the ledge. Zeus ult goes. They have vision of everybody. Might have gone early. BSJ ults. That I don't know about that ultimate at all.
Oh, I feel like with that ult, you either need to leave unless you can find someone right away.
Finger. Oh no, Mad's gonna Yules himself. RP. Oh, it misses. Sonic Wave blows up the disruptor. They do get the line. Meanwhile, the supernova, but they're not bringing it down. Can they fight this? Is this a possibility? They take down the supernova. Goodbye, Banana Slime GM. A triple kill for Ben Haas. He goes to work. Blink away from Brax just in time. Demon will TP out. They do buy back on Mad, but Roche is up, and Ben Haas will certainly kill it fast enough for them to secure the Aegis for one of their heroes. Who knows who picks it up? I don't know what you drop here for anybody.
Roshan has
drops the... gives up his treads to Zetok. That seems like the right choice. And they'll
they're
go straight down
the
mid.
Game right now.
This game's over if they take the set of racks.
And they're going to try to end it. I mean, they're going to need a miracle fight like the last one to make this happen. I don't know if they're going to get it. Phoenix is going to buy back. No supernova for 61 seconds. So that's certainly going to make things more complicated.
Yeah, I don't know if they make the same mistake with the four-man Earth Spikes. Matt already uses it down for 10 seconds. Clips back, doesn't really do anything. Skewer onto two. Banana Slam Jamma and Demon. Sonic Wave Ghost does nothing. Banana Slam Jamma. Ben Ha is going to get the kill. Two kills out already. Brax has to blink. They're getting herded back into the well. Icarus dive goes through as well. Madska going to back up as well. Brax is now exposed. Figure does nothing to Ben Haas. Mad is pranked for damage. Just can't quite get it. And they get another kill. Double kill for Papa Poito. They'll get three down. They'll get the GG. And we're moving on to game number three here tonight in Dota 2 Canada Cup.
Very impressive performance by Union Gaming. And I'm just to be honest, I mean, it seems like this draft sort of went the other way this time. Mag did some decent work. The Phoenix was really, really lacking. For fire, and honestly, Banana Slam Jamma did not impress on the Lycan. That was not an Arteezy level Lycan, that's for damn
sure.
Yeah,
how do you have such a good solid start in that first game and then have that kind of a game in the second?
I feel like he had no effect on the game. He was a hero in the game, but he had no effect on it, you know.
I'm gonna agree with you. That was something else coming out from Union though. They played a very solid game, and I don't know, man. What do you think of for game three?
I think it's going to come down to the draft. Seems like the last games have.
All right.
What I'm going to say.
Well, we'll see how the draft does end up here in game number three as we will take a quick break. And, of course, action brought to you by High Ground TV. Make sure you check us out at highground.tv, at High Ground TV on Twitter, at MottDota, at WhatIsUpTV, at MottPacks for us. We'll take a quick break. We'll jump into game number three in just a second. Stick around, guys.